Return to your heart, come home to Namaste. And it's really stuck with me because I just more and more experience and see the love that is given and received here. And those lives that are living and walking that path of truth and mutual support and admiration, and it's been awesome to witness. And earlier this week, I had received a call from Ed, who, as many of us are animal lovers, of course, we have our pets, we have our kitties, and we have our dogs, and some people have ducks, and geese, rather, and whatever it is, fish, whatever it is, chickens, goats, I don't want to forget anything, birds. So anyway, but the point I'm choosing to make is that we get very attached, and Ed's beloved Bodie managed to get into the garbage and eat a pound and a half of chocolate. And Ed, needless to say, was devastated, scared, upset, and called me very upset. And so anyway, he did what a good daddy does and took his dog to the vet. And then he went on to take Bodie to the emergency care clinic to get his stomach pumped. And then back again, home and back again. So it was a sad couple of days, a tough couple of days. Good news is Bodie's better. There's lots of miracles that came from this encounter. And it's such a tribute, I think, to just everything we believe and teach and practice here. And I wanted Ed to share this with you because it really is, in 2 days, how your life completely turned around. Right. So can you share this for a few minutes, and I'm going to give you a mic. You okay?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. So she basically laid the foundation for what had actually transpired in literally a 32-hour period. And you know, I don't generally get into my total personal life. My financial crisis with a lot of people, or I call it financial crisis yesterday, but I no longer do that today. And in fact, after this past 32 hours, I will no longer be able to use those words ever again. Because I have learned something about life and the energy of love that I wish and bless every single one of you to experience. I had not been doing well financially, and the reason I say that is because it's very pertinent to what actually transpired when Bodie got sick. I was living, like many people, at the skin of my teeth, juggling everything financially to be able to make ends meet, and that also included food, that included household bills and expenses. I had no heat in my house for the past, I still don't have heat in my house for the past 8 weeks, 9 weeks now. And the reason I say that is because the building blocks of all those things that I experienced that I was really struggling to gain a hold of, to be able to bring myself to a much higher level. Sometimes life drains you down and makes that very difficult to be positive, to stay in the light, to stay energetically to where there are no issues, there are no problems, there are no circumstances that cannot be overwhelmed by just pure faith and love. Well, Bodie got sick. I had received a check for the first time in 2 weeks. My phone was about ready to get turned off. I deposited the check through my phone, and it had not cleared, had not cleared, had not cleared. The morning that Bodie got into the trash, before he got into the trash, I checked my phone around, I guess it was around 6:30 in the morning, because I was so needing that money to pay my bill that I was anxious. So I checked my online thing. Finally, my money cleared and I had enough to pay my bill down. So I couldn't wait. That was one of my very primary tasks to do that morning. Bodie jumps out of bed at 7 o'clock in the morning, which was unusual for him. He gets back into the bed 15 minutes later with a fully wet muzzle. He is covered in chocolate. The night before, I had made, or the week before, I had made this four-layer extra chocolate DIY, my very first DIY chocolate cake. And I was very proud of it, and it was so heavy. It called for a container and a half of 100% pure dark cocoa powder and chocolate. 7 cups of confectioner's sugar.
Oh my gosh.
2.5 cups of raw sugar and 7 cups of flour. Vanilla and everything else you can imagine. I threw out that cake because it was so rich and so chocolatey that myself as a chocolate lover and a major sweet toothaholic could not eat the rest of this cake. Sitting on the counter, I was like, oh, there's no way. I threw it away the night before, put it in a bag, and went to throw it away, but it was pouring outside. So I decided to keep it in the bag at the door and wait for morning to throw it away. Everything that I threw away, with the exception of a very small piece, my little 14-pound dog, 17-pound dog, ate every bit of that cake and a container full of icing made of the same exact chocolate. I'm going to make it short because I know that the miracle is coming. Needless to say, I literally was beside myself because I had realized that my little guy had just poisoned himself. Anyway, I picked him up, raced him to the hospital, where they tried to induce vomiting to get it out. My little guy did not want to give up the cake. And trust me, they tried every kind of chemical that they could do that most dogs would have heaved for weeks. And as it turns out, he was much stronger than that. So we held on to his cake, and in the meantime, he was now digesting almost 2 pounds of pure cocoa powder chocolate. So, as you know, that even if you give your dog, if your dog gets into a Hershey bar, you'd be concerned.
Yeah.
If he raided your M&M's bucket, you'd be a little concerned. Double that by about 50 times. So, Edinburgh Animal Hospital could not, at this point, get it out of him. They referred me to REACH, which is an emergency medical care facility that has every bit of latest piece of equipment that they can get, and we knew that he was literally going down a very, very bad road. So they referred me to them. So all that money that had just cleared for my cell phone, and then some, went to pay my very early morning bill of over $200. And now I don't have my bill. Whew. So I race to the hospital with a very, potentially very sick dog. Get him to the emergency room. They're already waiting for me. They bring him inside. I fill out the paperwork. That afternoon, I was just given a bill of $550. I take him home at 5:30 after the whatever they can do. By the way, they showed me pictures. They pumped his stomach out, and they took pictures and weighed out 1.5 pounds of pure chocolate. At that point, his blood pressure was already starting to crash. His BP, or his pulse rate, went to 206 beats a minute. And he was now in very serious cardiac arrest emergency. I called Charlotte to ask her if she can help me financially to reach out to anybody that she could. Because I couldn't. Sorry. Anyway, boom, I'm gonna get back into the miracle. That'll make me feel better. Okay, so I go home with Bodie. They say, oh, he's ready to be released. We've gotten all the chocolate fit out. I take him home. Within the first 20 minutes of driving home, he's already had 2 epileptic seizures. in the car, and he was not responsive when he was going through this phase. I take him home to go potty, and he's now having seizures about every 10 minutes, and he's having involuntary convulsions on the floor. So I raise him back. Sorry. It was actually a pretty tough time. I had Charlotte on the phone about every 10 minutes. Like she needed to have that. And I asked her to help me out in every way that we could. I had no more money. I had no more resources. I'm taking him back to emergency care after already spending nearly $800. Then he's admitted to ICU, where he had to go and administer all his problems again. They end up trying to take more chocolate out of him because there was more left. He's now having neurological pathology through his brain, and he was at risk of cardiac arrest. We readminister him. He is now hooked up to a 24-hour or a time stay in ICU heart monitor, two more IVs, more medications to balance his blood pressure, more medications to lower his heart rate, and now we're watching to see what happens. I go back to pick him up the very next day after an overnight stay at ICU. He came out through the doors. Oh, let me tell you. I'm on the phone with Charlotte. Financial crisis. I'm dealing with already an emotional, very emotional time with Bodie. But I also have a very, very difficult time knowing how I'm going to leave this hospital with him, since they would probably call the police if I tried to take him out without paying the bill. The guy behind the counter sees me on the phone texting with Charlotte and three or four other people to try to gain some sort of financial aid to help me with this. This beautiful individual behind the counter comes over to me quietly and says, "I see that you're struggling to try to get your payment and the money for his bill. I have some applications over there. Let me see if we can put some through. But you're already stressing enough, so why don't you just fill out the top part of the application, leave the rest with me, and let me see if I can put it through my computer. And if your credit is good, then maybe we can get you some help." 7 minutes later, he comes out to me, calls me to the counter. He says, "You've just been approved for $1,000 full line credit for paying your bill with Care Credit. Granted, it is 27.5% interest, but if I pay it in less than 6 months, then I don't have to pay the interest, I just pay the bill. But then I get the bill for Bodie, and it's an additional $675. So now I've maxed out the card, and I still don't have the money. So he calls back up credit. They extend my credit up to pay the bill. I'm like, wow. Okay, so I'm great. One of the best things that happened to this whole thing is I got the chance to call Charlotte and say, "I no longer place this burden on you. I've got it covered." That was very exciting. So I didn't still have my bill paid. I run home with Bodie. Oh, so Bodie comes out of the doors. He's all whacked out. He's licking me up and down, and I could not tell you the relief I had from his recovery. He passed most of the toxins throughout the night. They did try to get more chocolate out of him, which is great, so he didn't have any more of his system. Now Bodie is now recovering very, very well. I get home to my mailbox after a beautiful, beautiful reunion with my little guy after what I've been through that night before. I open up my mailbox, and I open up the first envelope, and there's $40 in cash in there from my former neighbor, Pete, out of the blue. He didn't even know what was going on with Bodie. And just out of the blue, $40 in cash, and it reads, "I've just come up on some extra money." And there was some other thing about going on a date with some girl or something like that. And he says, "I would hate to see you have no gas to take on any dates. So here's $40 in gas just in case you needed it." I was like, wow. because to be honest, my car was in fumes. I open up the next envelope. There inside there is a cashier's check for $200 from a person that has their clothes and boxes in my storage unit. And she's not, I didn't tell her to pay this stuff. I didn't tell her that she needs to owe me for anything. But she says, I'm sorry I'm late. I haven't talked to you in a while, but here's $200 if it can help you. Wow. I take the $200, I pay my cell phone. That same exact morning, I get my very first call for my sister, and then my next call from Jeff Lott, who is the drummer of Shotgun Gypsies. And I say that in quotes, because this is very crucial. He calls me up and he says, Ed, we love you guys. We at Shotgun Gypsies, we love Bodie, we love you guys, we love your energy, and we want to be able to help. We know that you're going through a lot. We follow you on Facebook. We want to do a benefit concert to pay back everything you spent for Bodie. Now we're having a benefit concert at possibly the Sanctuary Brewery to raise all the money back to pay the bill. Wags, I told Wags about it, they love them to death, death as well. They're donating several hundred dollars worth of gifts and goods to the raffle. I went over to Vessel. My dear friend Chris and his sister are putting up $500 worth of amazing gifts to help pay back, to sell the tickets at the benefit concert. In short, we now have three bands who have volunteered to play music. We now have three rocking bands to play at his benefit. We've gotten already just two stores to put up nearly $700 worth of goods for the cause. As it turns out, and they're putting us on their email list, their websites, and everything else. So we're going to have their followings and their customer base. If we raise more money than Bodie's bill, I'll be putting a fund together for those people who can't afford their pet bill. It'll be a care project that I'm going to head up and put money into account to help those who had the same situation that I was in. Sanctuary will also be receiving some of the funds and proceeds from whatever we raised, because they are animal rescue company. That's why their brewery is called the Sanctuary for Pets, as well as the Blue Ridge Animal Shelter, where I originally adopted Bodie. We'll also get some of the proceeds if I can get over and above what his bill is. So Bodie got himself into trouble. He saved my life internally, because he made me realize, no matter how low I felt, no matter how desperate I was, keep the faith, keep the love, invite your friends and family in to share that love and connection with you. And there is nothing on this earth that is impossible, because God and the universe will provide every single thing you need and more. And that's my story.